Williams. Today is Wednesday, January 27th, 2021. It is a day three on your cycle. If you would please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right, so let's head over to Mr. Payne and see what our weather is going to be for today.
Thanks, Ms. Williams. That was fantastic. Hey, C.E. Cole, Wednesday morning, and here's your weather. You're waking up to cloudy conditions. Temperatures are in the 30s, and they're going to stay right there all day. And since that storm has moved out, it's leaving behind cloudy and breezy conditions that are going to take us until Friday. So if you get outside, you're going to feel that gentle breeze and temperatures are going to be pretty chilly. And tonight, it's going to go down into the upper 20s and still those clouds are going to be hanging around. All right, our question of the day comes from Clarissa Alvarado. And Clarissa asks, Mr. Payne, why is Neptune blue? All right, let's get out of Earth's atmosphere and let's travel all the way to the outer planet of Neptune. And why it's blue? Well, it has to do with the combination of gases, but the main gas that makes it that is methane. Now, methane absorbs the sunlight, but it only absorbs the red light, reflecting back blue light. And that is why Neptune is blue. What an awesome question. Thanks for that, Clarissa. Back to you, Ms. Williams. See you, Cole. Have a great Wednesday.
All right, thank you, Mr. Payne, for another great weather report. All right, today I have some facts for you about things that took place on January 27th in history. The first one I'm going to share with you is from 1945. The Nazi concentration camps that with about 6,000 prisoners, those prisoners were freed on this day in 1945 by the Soviet forces. In 1967, on the Apollo 1 shuttle, there was an electrical fire during the launch release, and it was in the cabin of the shuttle, and three pilots were killed during that electrical fire, which caused NASA to shut down all manned flights of Apollo shuttles for the next 20 months. 1976, let's see how many of you are familiar with this show. In 1976, Laverne and Shirley first aired. That was a spinoff from Happy Days. 1984, Michael Jackson, you should be familiar with him. Michael Jackson was filming a commercial, a Pepsi commercial, which I'm guessing was probably for the Super Bowl. And one of the pyrotechnics that was part of the commercial caught his hair on fire, and he received second-degree burns. So that was for the song Billie Jean. So Mr. Coldren, I hope you enjoyed that song this morning, and you and your class were dancing up a storm. 1991. Super Bowl 25, that was 30 years ago. In the Super Bowl 25, The New York Giants beat the Buffalo Bills 20-19. So that was a very close game there. And finally, in 2010, some of you, I'm sure, can appreciate this, Steve Jobs unveiled the Apple iPad. So that is now 11 years since he has done that. All right, and finally, it is a very important day. It is National Geographic Day, but even more importantly, it is National Chocolate Cake Day. So if you have some free time today or after school, go ahead and bake yourselves and your family a nice chocolate cake. Don't forget, a couple of reminders, you should be plugging in and shutting down your Chromebooks every single night. So in case there are any updates, your computers will get updated. Lunch and breakfast pickup is still every day between 10:30 and 1 o'clock at the MEC playground. And that's all I have for today. Enjoy your Wednesday.